Jillian Birdie.
And I'm Killeen Wright.
Welcome to Louder News.
Recently, there have been some accidents in the Ursuline parking lot, and students are complaining about the too small spaces. We sent some reporters over to check it out.
Hi, my name's Jenna.
And I'm Catherine.
And we're coming to you live from the Ursuline parking lot, where we've done some research on how wide the Ursuline parking spaces are compared to minimum standard size parking spaces, which are 9 feet.
Would you look at that?
This spot's only 7.5 feet.
That's 7.5 feet. That's a whole foot and a half shorter than it should be.
This seems to be the reason why there have been so many car accidents in the UA parking lot recently. We spoke to some students to see what they thought.
Ugh, I'm sorry, Catherine. I had to climb out of the trunk of my car just to get out of my car.
Oh no.
So Alex, how do you feel about this parking situation?
I think it's terrible. I mean, like, the spots are so close together. When you park, you're pretty much bound to hit somebody when you open your door. I mean, you can look at my side car if you would like to. It's all banged up.
What if I told you that the spots are only 7.5 feet wide?
Are you serious?
They're supposed to be 9.
This is ridiculous!
I decided to try to climb out of one of the cars myself. As you can see, it wasn't easy.
Thanks, Catherine and Jenna. Sounds like a disaster out there.
Oh, it sure does, Jillian. Next up, we have a health report for you.
Seniors everywhere are already suffering from senioritis. Symptoms include not doing any homework, daydreaming about college, spending most of your time in the senior lounge, and being tired all the time.
We had some reporters go and interview a few of the girls about their symptoms.
Over the weekend, instead of doing my mayor essay or my comrade speech or any other homework, I marathoned all 3 High School Musicals. Good time.
Okay. Senioritis, good or bad?
No comment.
Senioritis as a varsity athlete, how is that making you feel?
Well, because I don't do any homework, I have more time to train to be a varsity athlete, which is always helpful.
That's great. So do you only train instead of doing homework? What else do you do?
Occasionally, I will watch every single YouTube video of Kara Rose DP99 has ever made on YouTube, and I like to eat cookies.
Do you think the cure to senioritis will ever be found?
No.
Did you know that King Tut was very attractive?
Oh, actually.
How do you know that?
We watched a movie in art history. So
it's not the
it's
actual
factual.
King Tut.
So tired of the straight line.
What a devastating disease.
I personally am still struggling with it myself.
As many of you know, the juniors held a bake sale recently with Mrs. Manning. We spoke to Corinne Hajar about the cause.
So recently, pictures have come up of refugees washed up on the shore and the awful conditions in which they're living in. And all these Syrian refugees fleeing the war in Syria need money, resources, and a place to live. So the junior class, along with Miss Manning, we all decided to get together and do this bake sale to raise money for our brothers and sisters in the Middle East.
What a great idea. I personally purchased mini cupcakes.
Me too.
Now for Bear Beauty. We have some great uniform tips for all of you.
Here we have the perfect example of an Ursuline uniform. Notice how our friend Allison has no uniform violations. See how her skirt gently brushes her knees, and her lovely tan Sperry's follow uniform code. Now see underneath her beautiful Ursuline sweater there is a uniform polo. It's navy because she's a senior, and that bright smile on her face completes the look.
I'm Ian Birdie, and this is Bear Beauty. So today I'm going to be showing you some typical Ursuline hairstyles and makeup routines. I'm going to start out with the makeup look. For this look, you'll need concealer and mascara. So first, I'm going to start out with the concealer. So you take out this wand and you dab a little bit under your eye and then rub it in to cover up the dark spots from not sleeping. Next, I'm going to apply the mascara. So you take out this little wand and brush it right onto your lashes, but be careful not to cry it off during the day. Now that we're done with the makeup, let's move on to the hairstyles. So the first step to the typical Ursuline hairstyle is to take out your hair in its current style. The first step is to bunch your hair up onto the top of your head, like so. Just like this, right up on the top, very top. Once the hair is all gathered at the very top of your head, you need to wrap it up into a bun, like this. So just take in and wrap it around and around until it is in a bun formation, like this. Once your hair is wrapped up in this bun, you need to take a ponytail and wrap it around the bun and make sure it's nice and secure and tight. Now that your hair is in this tight, secure bun, it's time to add the headband, which must be Lululemon. And there's two options. There's the skinny one or the thicker one. So I'm going to choose the thicker one today. And you put it over your head like this. Make sure all the hair's under there so it doesn't fly away. You put it over your face just like this. Stick it right there. Keep all your hair back. That's it for today. I'm Jillian Birdie, and this is Bear Beauty.
I've seen so many of those hairstyles around school, and those uniform tips were very helpful.
Well, that's it for today's news.
Thanks for watching. We hope you have a great day. Recently, there have been some accidents in the Ursuline Park.
Hello, I'm Jillian Murdy.
Everything else must be silent.
Oh my god, I'm gonna drop something. I didn't.
What?
You're supposed to be nine.
This is an outrage!
I only call you when it's
time. Kaya, we're filming.
Kaya!